Michelle Visage, and you're watching Jamar 84's YouTube channel. You better work.
Yes.
What's going on, YouTube?
Jamar.
What's going on, YouTube?
Washington.
This is what Jamar 84 here once again.
Hey, what's going on, YouTube? This is your boy Jamar 84 here once again, here to discuss episode 4 of RuPaul's Drag Race Season 9. Now, I think we can all say this unanimously, say it with me. This, so far, has been the best episode. This was an actual episode of Drag Race. It had, 99% of the components that I expect from an episode of Drag Race. Without the mini challenge, I didn't even need a mini challenge this time because we got the shade, we got the teary moment, we got, you know, resolution between people who had issue with one of another. We had, we had a great lip sync, but we did not. We'll get to that. We'll get to that. But this was definitely the best episode thus far, and I'm actually excited to talk about this one. Now, so we start off with, you know, Aja still having a thorn in her side about Valentina, and even was it Alexis, Michelle, somebody else chimed in with just like, oh well, you know, yeah, I kind of feel the same way because blah blah blah. But here's the thing, I understand how that can be frustrating, but you guys are sort of falling into a trap, and I don't know if it's necessarily the editors, the judges, or Valentina herself. Because by you behaving this way, it makes Valentina look better. Because it makes Valentina look like she's more mature, looks like she, just has more poise. She's not responding negatively to, you know, you guys feeling like she's being, what's the word I'm looking for? Overrated or whatever you want to call it. So you're kind of falling for a trap and making yourself look bad. And what made him look even worse was that Valentina the whole time was just trying to say, you know, I hear that you're talking about me, and I feel like you should just focus on, you know, what you need to focus on yourself, and don't try to look for other people. Like, she made herself look better while you guys kept looking stupid. Oh, bless it. She said in a confessional, like, you know, Aja comes off as being so confident, but the first time they say something to her, she wants to lash out and be, you know, all defensive. And I'm like, so you can't be doing that. You can't. So many times people come to this competition feeling like they can come in because they're sickening in wherever region that they're from, that they can just come here and I'm just gonna slay, when that's not the case. She picks certain people who are all the best in their respective fields. Now when we're here, it's a matter of who can be the best in this certain amount of time with these challenges, with the critiques that's given, who can come out and be the most proactive at listening to the judges and doing what they're supposed to do. So next we get, you know, the challenge is supposed to be, we're supposed to be broken up into two teams between two morning talk shows. And I'm like, okay, this is finally a chance for them to kind of show, to actually have more of a challenge. Because the first few challenges were mostly look-based, which is nothing wrong with that, but it just didn't really give a chance to see what the queens can do, like, to just come up with something on their own as far as, like, presenting the personality, the charisma part, okay? So now that we have this talk show, they have to kind of come up with their own lines and their bits between, you know, their partners. And the team lead for the first talk show, what was it, Morning Bitches, was Aja, because she survived the lip sync last week, and the other team was Trinity, because she won last week. So they're in their teams, and we're going to go over to Trinity's side, because, you know, Trinity at first was saying, okay, we want to make sure that we, you know, handle this the right way, this, that, and the four, being, you know, really, I don't want to say political, but being, you know, trying to be fair about it. And apparently, you know, Eureka would just kind of button in, like, you know, oh, not today, say, not on today, that's what their morning talk show was called. It's like, well, not on today kind of sounds ghetto. And, you know, I feel like we can do X, Y, and Z, da, 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 da. And Trinity was kind of, you know, trying to interject. And I guess she felt like, you know, Eureka was just talking over her and mowing her down. And she was like, you know, no, I don't feel like we should do that. And Trinity just kind of started assigning parts. She said, well, I feel like me and you would have, talking to Peppermint, we would have the chemistry, so we're going to be the anchors. Nina, you're good at constructing things, so you can do the DIY. Cynthia and Charlie, you guys are entertainment. So she just kind of assigned it, as opposed to, I guess, asking who would feel the best at doing what. And I think that's what Eureka was looking for. But, I mean, honestly, I don't see how the assignments really would have worked any better than they did, honestly, because Eureka and Nina were naturals in theirs. Charlie and Cynthia, I wouldn't have known how to make that better. But we're gonna get to that. But before we go over, Eureka felt like Trinity was being a dictator as opposed to a leader because she assigned the roles. But in fact, I feel like that's kind of what a leader does. I feel like she could have assigned the roles, but you could have attested. It's not like what she said was law. If she said something that you felt like you would have been a better, you could have raised your hand like she said you could do and said, well, you know, I feel like I could do better at such and such. But it didn't feel like you were really giving like an alternative solution to what she gave you. So I'm not sure why Eureka was complaining. And then she tried to, and then even on the other side, when Eureka did try to raise her hand, I guess while she was talking to Peppermint, Trinity was just kind of like being a little bit shady, like, girl, I really don't even want to hear what you have to say right now. But she has to abide by the rules that she just gave. But it was just kind of messy. Moving forward to Charlie and Cynthia, this was kind of frustrating because y'all know I love me some Cynthia. Y'all know I love me Miss Cuckoo. But Charlie was exhibiting those control freak attributes. She in the confessional mentioned how if you add additional words, it can ruin the joke. If you leave out some words, it can ruin the joke, which in all in turn is true. But at the same time, some of the best comedy is comedy that's off the dome, comedy that is just come straight from a person's personality. If somebody just has natural inklings about themselves that are funny, let them use those natural inklings about themselves that are funny. She was trying to basically take Cynthia, who already doesn't speak the best English, okay? We understand what she's saying, but she's not going to speak like the proper English to where you can critique her on every little enunciation part and try to make everything very, very rehearsed, you know? And it was kind of frustrating to watch. Now, mind you, I love Charlie. I think it was a couple weeks back at this point, I got to meet her here at South Beach. I'll put that picture up in a sec. But this time, I feel like she just wasn't shown in the most positive light, especially up against Cynthia, who, even though a lot of people don't like that she's back, I still love her and will always love her. I'm going to be rooting for her and Nina this season. But I just felt like it was very ugly from what she had showcased. So now we get to the challenge. And it's Aja's team that goes first. And Aja and Valentina are doing the entertainment thing. Pheromone and Alexis, they were fine. They were perfect. They did their parts. Nothing wrong with them. We move forward to Valentina. Who was that? Valentina and Aja, who I guess were doing like the entertainment, like tooting boot of people's looks. And the pictures were warped. I'm like, that was weird. But they tried. You could tell that Aja and Valentina were trying because you could see how they were trying to get the jokes together, but it didn't land. I'm not sure what it was about it that made it seem awkward, or I don't know. It was very strange. They were trying to, you know, be funny and be shady a little bit, and it wasn't connecting. It just wasn't. And I was afraid that they were gonna put Aja back in the bottom too. I was like, oh Lord. Let's see, where are we? Sasha Velour and Shea Coulee doing the, I guess, try to incorporate RuPaul chocolate into your everyday diet. That was probably the best part of the whole, one of the best parts of the whole episode. because they looked like they was about to kiss. First of all, she looked really good in that yellow dress. I'm not sure if it was the contrast of the skin tone to the dress, but she looked really, really good in that short wig. But her and Sasha were like trying to do like a play, kai kiss type situation. And they played it up really, really funny. And they just really hammed it up and made it so entertaining that even the other people on the team were laughing. It was, as soon as they did their scene, I knew they were going to win. I knew that without a doubt. Then we move over to the other team. And it starts with the news anchor between Trinity and Peppermint. Now, again, this was a situation where they tried to set something up to be a joke, and it just didn't come off right. I understood where they were going with it, and I was almost there with Peppermint. I felt like that role, she kind of played it really well, but I think I want to say that kind of fell more on Trinity. But in the end, they said how they don't really want to see people being catty on morning TV. I personally, it would wake me up. They said, oh, he needs to be light. I would be more interested and more inclined to wake up if I knew there was going to be a couple of shady people on my TV going back and forth. That would be more interesting. That would perk me up, start my day off right. I would be laughing at them. But so I didn't agree with that critique, but you know, to each his own. But they did kind of bomb that. They were trying to do like some kind of, your makeup is this, there's something going around saying that something in people's makeup bag is making them look bad. And she's like, oh, well, girl, you need to throw away your whole makeup bag because da-da-da-da. She's like, well, one thing I found in my makeup bag was your husband's business card and da-da-da. And I mean, I get it. I swear I get it, but no. It just didn't. I don't know if it was felt rushed. I'm not sure what it was or what was missing from the formulation of that joke to make sense, but it just wasn't good. They tried to say a story about, Nicki Minaj, Michelle Visage, you know, having like a breast reduction or something like that. And Peppermint tried to say a line about the only two breasts I want is two breasts and a biscuit or something, like a KFC special. And she tried, but she fumbled the words, bless her heart. But at least she didn't look, at least it wasn't cringeworthy when she fumbled the words, because she could tell she was laughing at herself. So it kind of made it a little bit easier to watch. And let's see, where we move on to, Chad? Charlie and Cynthia. Oh, now this was cringeworthy because you could tell that the whole time Charlie was sitting there reading by the book. She was not trying to veer off. She had everything from beginning to end rehearsed. She wasn't going to veer off. She wasn't going to be no ad-libbing, none of that. But, and Cynthia mentioned before when they were rehearsing, like, you can't try to make me into something that I'm not, because it's not going to translate well, which is exactly what happened to Charlie. Charlie was trying so hard to be so by the book and strict, then Cynthia just kind of like, look, I'm going to kind of wing this. I'm still going to, you know, be privy to what's on the card, but I need to liven this up. Let me throw some Cynthia in this, like, make this a little bit more interesting, because I feel like whatever Charlie had was going to be drop dead and boring. No shade, but I just, from the way that he was constructing that, I was not feeling that at all. And I'm so glad that Cynthia was there to save it with her charm and loveliness. So I love you, Cynthia. Nina and Eureka. This is like how Shea Coulee and Sasha Velour was in the first team. They were so funny. I was worried because I didn't know. You just never know. And they was talking about how, you know, you have an expensive wig that can be like $7,500. And they said, oh, well, you've been doing it wrong. All you need to do is go to get you a good EBT card, get you some ramen noodles, put you a whole wig on. Like, it really felt like those weren't rehearsed lines. Like, the way that Nina and Eureka delivered their section, it felt like they didn't even rehearse it. And then in a good way, like, it just came natural. And it was so funny. And it was like, oh, well, you know how typical butt pad can cost like $200 per cheek. And then it was like, nope, see, you've been doing it all wrong, girl. You go to the grocery aisle, get you some ham. But you know what? Secretly, as they were trying to be a joke, I feel like that can actually be the truth for some of these queens who just don't have it right now, but they need to get that gig. And they don't have those hip pads, but you can get you a nice pair of ham hocks from the store. I'm just saying. I mean, it was a joke, but secretly, some of y'all need to follow that for real, for real. But that was definitely the best part of that particular team. Very natural and very funny. So to get to the interview part, each team had like a part where they're supposed to interview Naya Rivera, I believe that's her name. And the first team, it was fine. It was smooth. Great. But the second team, when it came to the part where there's supposed to be an ending, I guess Trinity and Peppermint, who were supposed to be acting as the anchors, didn't realize that it was supposed to be ending. And, excuse me, Charlie was kind of looking like, okay, I see that it's supposed to end. I have an option. I have a decision to make. Do I just let them handle it because it's not really my job? Or do I try to take it upon myself to just end the interview in hopes that it might save the group? Where Charlie decided to go with option B and end the interview in a well, thanks for going. We're going to go to commercial. And everybody's kind of looking like, what do we do here? Like, do we just get up and leave? Like, everybody was kind of confused as to what they're supposed to do. And I don't even know what would have been the best decision in that case. I think, I want to say she made the better decision, potentially, because she didn't want to it to go out into a situation where Rue would be like, well, you guys know the time was right. Why did nobody say nothing? So, I don't know. I don't know if doing it either way would have helped it. It was just basically more important for Trinity and Peppermint to be paying a lot more closer attention. So this elimination day, everybody's getting ready to do their runways, and it's like the naughty, nighty runway. And as they're getting ready, Charlie asks, I believe, Cynthia about, you know, what does she do in terms of awareness for HIV. She says that she works with recently diagnosed patients. And then Charlie talks about how he came out roughly around the time when HIV and AIDS was before it was ever really like an epidemic, where people, you know, that was in his age group were spreading the virus without knowing that, before the virus had a name, before we even knew what it was or how it worked, you know, people were just having, you know, reckless, unsafe sex. And that's how initially the crisis had spread, and how she had to bury a lot of her friends and best friends. You know, that's definitely hard, especially when you don't know or understand what it is that's happening at the time. So I could definitely feel for her in that moment. And it's always good. Make sure you guys practice safe sex. It's always the best practice. Now, this is a very strange argument that came up later on, because somebody was saying something light about, oh, you know, I have morning breath sometimes. I have, I can't remember what the sickness, it's not psoriasis, it's something else. I can't remember what somebody else mentioned. And then Valentina said, oh, you know, do you guys want to know about this disorder that I've been fighting with my whole life? And Eureka chimes in, and I guess she was trying to say like eating disorder to kind of be funny, I guess because she thinks that Valentina is thin, making a joke. But apparently that triggered Sasha for real, because, you know, she's like, girl, don't do that, girl. That's not funny. It's not, you know, appropriate to bring up eating disorders, this, that, and the fourth. And for some reason, Eureka took that the wrong way and tried to say like, oh, you were coming at me negative, and, you know, it was a joke. I was trying to be lighthearted, this, that, and the fourth. But here's the thing. First of all, she didn't come at you negative, okay? Sasha came at you in the lightest and most polite way possible, really. I feel like if that was a lot of other people, they would have came at you the real negative way, and, you know, that would have went really left. But she said, no, don't joke about that, girl, because that's not funny. A lot of people have approached me and told me, you know, oh, you need to eat, you're anorexic or something like that, and that's something that she's dealt with personally, so it's not really funny to her. You can't get mad when you try to be lighthearted and the joke just accidentally offends someone. You just say, oh, you know, I didn't mean to, you know, I really didn't mean to offend you. I just thought I was trying to make a light joke, and that'd be it. Don't get mad when the other person who's offended, you know, has a genuine reason to be offended. And Shea Coulee came in Sasha's defense, like, she's not being nasty. She's not, you know, coming at you in any kind of way. She was just trying to make sure that every part of this conversation is appropriate and respectful to everybody involved. So that's why I was kind of like, Eureka, girl, I don't know what you think you're doing. It's not really cute. I'm really trying to get into you, and I haven't been enthused since you walked into the workroom. So, girl, I'm going to need you to chill out. For real, for real. So we get to these runways. Now, as you know, for some reason, whenever they do the runways and there's a lot of girls, they just really swipe past them really fast. So I have them pulled up here on my iPad. Now, I don't need to talk about necessarily every single runway because, again, this video will be really, really long. I just want to mention those that I think were really, 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 really good or that were really, 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 really bad. So the ones that I deem as my personal favorite, that would fall under Sasha Velour, Shea Coulee, Valentina. Valentina, that red, that looks really, really good on her. And Pheromone. Pheromone had like a little white, real cute nightgown. That was really, really nice. And of course, Nina Bonina Brown. Now, I know it's going to be seen biased because Nina's my girl. But I was really waiting for her to run this outfit because I saw this in the promo. And granted, she does look like a $2 hooker. But you know what? I still live for it because of the skeleton bone facial makeup. I still live for it. And that body is still incredible. So I still just love my Nina. Now, the people who are awful to me were Eureka. That was bad. That was really bad. That did not accentuate nothing. She really looked like she just had like a black cloth with a pink corset over it. And I was not enthused. Charlie, it really looked like just a straight up nightgown. Like it wasn't like a drag nightgown, like something exaggerated. It just looked like something you could have bought off the rack. I mean, mind you, she had some drag type shoes that were 10 feet off the ground, but just as the overall look, it was very meh. Peppermint. Oh, baby, peppermint. 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 What is this, peppermint? Why is your fupa showing through? Well, it's not really a fupa. But no, it's way too short. Like, we have been complaining to Peppermint wearing these long robes, and then she decides to wear a short. Now it's too short. Like, girl, find a good medium. Bless her heart, but Peppermint, no. Let's see, nobody else's was bad, and everybody else's was just regular safe or just not really, you know, anything to cry home about, basically. So the girls were brought back, and Shea Coulee and Sasha Bell, so I don't know why I just called her Sasha. Sasha Velour won the challenge, which is very much well deserved. I think they definitely killed it. And they were asked the question, because everybody else on the other team, you know, is up for elimination, which I don't think is the right words to use because you're just critiquing them. I wouldn't necessarily say they're all up for elimination and then tell them that they're safe later. That was weird. But they asked him who all should go home. Now, I know this is one of my favorite questions because this always stirs up drama for Untucked. This Untucked is going to be really good. Trinity said, I think everybody said Charlie. No, Trinity and Eureka said each other. Peppermint and Charlie said each other. And everybody else said, no. Wait, let me start that over. Yeah, Charlie and I guess Trinity got the most votes, basically. Some people said Charlie. Some people were saying Trinity because she was the leader. And of course, Eureka and Trinity said each other because they're petty the whole episode. And then when they were critiquing Nina decided to cry, and I wasn't sure. I'm like, did she get a harsh critique? And she's like, no, she was crying because she was just, ooh, excuse me. I was holding that back for a long time. I just couldn't wait no more. But she was crying because she just had a moment where she just realized, you know, I guess I'm in RuPaul's Drag Race season 9. I've made it roughly almost halfway through the season and I've done really well to this point. And she just had a moment where she just cried tears of joy, being happy to be there. I was like, oh, okay, well, that's good. So they said that they loved her, but they wanted her to be like, you know, I want you to make sure that you can develop, you know, some tough skin, because this competition, you know, you're going to need much tougher skin to continue to progress through the competition. And I feel like that was sound advice. I don't feel like it was insensitive or anything, but I guess they want to make sure that her sensitivity doesn't get in the way of her progress, so to speak. So they bring all the girls, you know, they do all the deliberation, and it's Charlie versus Trinity in the lip sync. Now, there have been quite a few queens during all the seasons of RuPaul's Drag Race who said that if I ever have to go up and lip sync, I'm just gonna stand there and watch you perform and cheer you on because I already know I can't win. A lot of people have said that. And namely, what I think in mind is the two times this happened is in season 7, where Jasmine said she was gonna sit there and watch Kennedy perform. Katia said she was gonna sit there and watch Kennedy perform because they just know she's gonna be, you know, kicking and flipping and doing everything. But even when they said that, when it came down to it, both of them actually really tried to perform. You know, Jasmine did her squats, okay, and she tried to perform a song. Katia did her splits and she gave it her all. Even though they still lost, they tried. Whereas this time, Charlie just, at first it was a Britney song. Now, I Wanna Go was one of my favorite songs from that Femme Fatale album back in the day. It was back in 2011. And, you know, it's a really upbeat, poppy song, you know, typical Britney. And Trinity is out there flipping, dipping, swipping her hair. That's not a real word. Flipping her hair and, you know, doing all this extra stuff in her little two-piece. And Charlie over here doing this. Like, what? Now, mind you, I will give Charlie this. First of all, she had on 10-inch heels, which I wouldn't have worn on the day of potential lip sync, but you know what, to each his own. And I watched on her, I saw a picture on her Instagram earlier tonight before I started the camera that she apparently had a broken rib, and that's why she couldn't lip sync. But at the same time, I just thought about this just now. If you had a broken rib the whole time of this competition, how were you able to do that cheerleading challenge? When you did that cartwheel. They wouldn't have even had you doing a cartwheel if they knew you had a broken rib, girl. All right. But either way it goes, I mean, it wasn't really a lip sync because Charlie just stood there and already knew. He said, I'm just waiting for RuPaul to say sashay away. And I guess because he said, you know, all the acts in London are, you know, live acts, and I knew that if I ever went into the bottom, I was going to go home. Well, girl, but you should still make for good TV to try. It just kind of takes away, like, if I were Trinity, I would be happy, of course, to stay in the competition still, but I would feel some type of way that I just won this by basically default, you know? But that's neither here nor there, but this was definitely a much better episode. I can't wait to see Untucked tomorrow morning, because usually I would usually wait until after Untucked to do the videos, but I'm just like, nah. It's usually never enough to include. If there is anything, I'll just include it in next week. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any comments, leave it down below. Who do you think is going to go home next? What do you think is going to be expected in the next episodes? Leave it down below, and I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.
Like, share, subscribe.
Jamar. Washington.